By Monday night, the red carpets really will be rolled out here at the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles. And there'll be a lot of pressure on Graham Greene because he's wearing so many labels. First of all, he's a Canadian, nominated for a major acting award. And then he's a native Indian. But whether he wins an Oscar or not, it doesn't really matter. Because he's been the vital part of something that's quite rare, a film that actually changes the way people see things.
Graham Greene is a very successful actor, winning up to 13 awards. He is well known for his positive and dignified roles he plays in film. Side note, none of the awards he has won have had the word Indian or Indigenous in them. Greene was born June 22, 1952 in Oswecan, Ontario on the Six Nations Reserve. The actor worked on stage, in film, and in TV productions in Canada, the United Kingdom, and the United States. His parents are Lillian and John Greene. His first experience in the entertainment industry came when he worked as an audio technician for multiple rock bands based in Newfoundland and Labrador, where he used an alias, Mavis. In 1974, Greene graduated from the Native Theatre School program in a Toronto-based Centre for Indigenous Theatre. This led to him performing in Indigenous theatres across Toronto and England. His TV debut was in an episode of The Great Detective in 1979, and 4 years after that, he scored his screen debut in the 1983 movie Running Brave. However, it was his Academy Award-nominated role as Kicking Bird in the 1990 film Dances with Wolves that really brought him to fame. I'm going to provide a slight trigger warning for this next story. It's short, but it does talk about suicide. In 1997, however, Greene suffered a major depressive episode that led to his being hospitalized after a police encounter. Some sources state that he recovered after getting help from Bruce Wills and Samuel L. Jackson. The story read that his neighbors called the police because they were concerned that he might try to harm himself. The story goes on to say that he was going through a hard time with some of his family and friends at the time. Even the greats can experience hardship. In film, Greene prefers to play roles that exist outside of his ethnicity or gender, such as a New York cop in the Die Hard with Vengeance movie from 1995. Even when playing an Indigenous role, he is first an ironically deft comedian, which can be seen in his popular television series The Red Greene Show, and in Dudley the Dragon, which won the 1994 and the 1998 Gemini Awards for Best Performance in a Children's Program.
I played all kinds of things. I played an old Jewish man in a furniture store and theater. I played a ghost of a black transvestite.
Who hasn't?
Well, who hasn't? Yeah, I had to jump out of a window at the end carrying my high heels and my underwear. It was really strange play. I played British soldiers, I played French soldiers, I played New York cops, I played lawyers, so.
Do you ever feel like you were stereotyped?
No.
Never?
No.
As a matter of fact, did you know that Graham Greene has appeared in over 100 films and TV series since 1979? His characters are almost always positive and very dignified. Greene wants to be seen as a capable actor that can take any role he is given before he's seen as an Indigenous actor or activist.
Actually changes the way people see things.
So when you hear that, what do you think? Everybody always got to put a label, like a Graham Greene, native actor. They don't say, like, so-and-so, black actor, so-and-so, the Vietnamese actor, so-and-so. They don't say that. They just
say
so-and-so.
No, but they used to, though. They used to. It's just taking time, right?
Yeah, but it's, I don't know, how many years is it going to be? This has been 30 years. Come on, you know, give it up.
Greene has become a strong role model and has proved that there is a space for Indigenous actors outside of the Western genre. However, despite what you may think, he considers himself neither a spokesperson for Native rights or a, quote, trailblazer that is paving the way for other Indigenous actors in the film and television industry. Instead, Greene prefers to think of himself as simply an actor that is capable of taking any role that comes his way.
Pan-Indianism, where everybody thinks that everybody is from the same nation and is the same people.
Oh, I know, I know. Everybody thinks, you know, oh, we did that movie, what was it called, with the costume fellow?
Dancing with Wolves?
That's it.
Yes, oh, yeah, the movie you got the Oscar nomination for?
Oh, that one, yes.
That one, yeah.
So anyway, It took I think 3 months to learn the language. I mean, I was working at it 8 hours a day to learn this language. I had no idea what I was saying. Just when somebody else stopped, I started talking. That's all.
The unit of study that would best fit Graham Greene's career would be unit number 3. Greene, often avoiding playing a stereotypical Indigenous person and looking to play roles that look at Indigenous people as humans rather than fantasy characters, is something that Hollywood needed and continues to work on a lot more. This actor has been at the center of a lot of change within the film industry, and I think it is safe to say that when he looks back at his career during retirement, he will be happily surprised to see a drastic change in representation as the world works towards reconciliation through all aspects of life. If you're looking to celebrate this actor as well, some films that I would recommend are the 2021 film Antlers, the 1999 film The Green Mile, and the 2021 film that just hit the theaters in March of this year, The Wolf and the Lion. Happy screening, everyone!